What is an encoder and how does it work? Welcome to today's tutorial. In today's tutorial, we will discuss about encoder and how does it work and its application in the industry. Before starting, I would request you guys to please subscribe this channel to stay connected and press the bell icon to get notified when we upload a new video tutorial. Encoder in a layman language is a rotating shaft which is enclosed in a round shape enclosure. When encoder shaft is connected to a rotating conveyor shaft or a motor shaft, it outputs some pulses. For example, if we have an encoder with 1024 pulses per revolution, this means that the encoder will output 1024 pulses in one complete revolution of its shaft. These pulses can be used to detect the position, speed, or a distance traveled by the conveyor belt. If we remove the back cover of the encoder, here you will find a glass plate connected to the shaft. This glass plate has a circular array of the small holes on it. This glass plate is very fragile. If you ever need to remove the encoder from the shaft of the motor, never use hammer or force to remove the encoder. It can damage the glass plate. Near to the glass plate, you will find a light source on the one side, and on the opposite side, you will find a light detector circuit. This light source is continuously emitting a beam of light. As the encoder shaft rotates, the glass plate also rotates with it. As soon as the light beam and the hole in the glass plate becomes aligned, the light beam passes through the hole and the light detector picks up this light beam signal. This signal is then amplified and converted into the digital pulse output signal. This is a very simple example. How does an encoder work and what's inside it? Encoder have three output pulse channels called as A, B, and Z phase. We will discuss about these phases later in this video tutorial. Original encoder glass plates looks like this, with some groove tracks on it. These groove tracks are for A, B, and Z phase encoder output channels. This means that there will be three separate light beam sources and three light beams detectors in the encoders for A, B, and Z output phase. When encoder shaft rotates, this glass plate also rotates. The light beams, whenever aligned with the grooves, passes through the groove and picked up by the light beam detectors. These signals then amplified and converted into digital pulses, and encoder finally gives out digital pulse signals at A, B, and Z phase. Most of the encoders will use 5 wires. You can refer their data sheets for the operating voltage and output phases of the encoder. The standard color coding for the encoder wiring is as following. Black wire will be A phase output channel, white wire is B phase channel, and the orange wire is Z phase channel. Brown and blue wire will be 24 volt DC power. If you want to learn how to connect an encoder with the PLC, you can click here for the complete video tutorials for encoder wiring and PLC programming. Now let's discuss more about the output channels of the encoder. We will see how does we can detect encoder is rotating in clockwise or anti-clockwise directions. To understand this, we have to understand the output sequence of these A, B, and Z channels. Let's suppose encoder shaft starts to rotate in the clockwise direction. The Z phase output pulse goes high first, and then A phase output goes high. This pattern of output pulses shows that the encoder is starting to move in the clockwise direction. B phase turn on after the A phase goes high. The duration of the Z phase will be equal to A plus B phase. Now let's suppose the encoder shaft starts to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction. The Z phase and B phase output pulse goes high at the same time, and then A phase output goes high after some time. This pattern of output pulses shows that the encoder is started to move in the anti-clockwise direction. The duration of the Z phase will be equal to A plus B phase. These patterns of the output pulses are detected by the PLC input channel, and the PLC controller can detect the direction of the rotation of the encoder and accordingly can plus or minus the current position or the degrees of the encoder shaft. Encoders can be used in the industrial automation for a number of applications. Let's suppose if we connect an encoder to the conveyor belt shaft, we can detect the direction of the belt, whether it's running in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. Encoder can give precisely the current position of the belt. We can make the logic in the PLC to convert the pulses into the meters and can detect how many meters the conveyor belt have traveled from the home position. Another important thing, we can detect the speed of this conveyor belt. We can detect how many meters or feet conveyor belts have traveled in 1 minute. In this way, we can get the speed of the conveyor belt in meter per minute or feet per minute. So that's the end of the today's tutorial. I hope you like it. Please share, like, and subscribe for more video tutorials. Till next time, take care and goodbye.